Welcome back. You're watching Trading Hour. Now let's put the spotlight on Maruti. We have some news coming in. Stock is, by the way, down about 1% as we speak. The news that my colleague Anu Sharma is picking up is that the festive season anyway has been fairly dull. And after that, the company is offering discounts as high as 90,000 rupees on certain models to get sales moving. Anu, what are the details? Which of these models? What are you picking up?
So it has been a dull festival season for automobile makers, and to give that extra push, the year-end discounts are here. And a review of discounts this time and same period last year shows that on most models, the discounts are higher than last year, indicating that car makers are giving that extra push amid a dull festival season due to lackluster consumer sentiment. The country's largest manufacturer of cars, Maruti Suzuki, sources tell us, is providing up to 80% higher total savings than November, which include cash discount, exchange bonus and other benefits. Its best-selling sports utility vehicle, Vitara Brezza, for the first time since its launch, is being offered with an exchange bonus of around 25,000 rupees. The company is not only giving exchange bonus on cars under 7 years old, but also beyond. Cars such as Alto, Desire, Baleno, S-Cross, Swift are being offered with up to 50% higher savings than November. While other automobile makers will also be offering steep discounts this month, we'll have to see whether these steep discounts and offers get converted into actual deals on the ground level.
Anu, thanks very much for that. So that is discounts galore as far as the auto space is concerned, with Maruti by far the biggest player in the passenger car segment, leading the way. Yes Bank alert at the bottom of your screen. It'll come up again. I mean, actually, it has picked up from the day's low by quite a bit, even as the market hasn't noticeably gained. I mean, so it's up 1%, 1.25% or so, 180 plus. So not quite at the day's high, which was the opening, but getting there. Well, the other story, of course, has been the IL&FS hearing at the NCLT. The government has sought the approval of the Company Law Tribunal to freeze and attach the assets of key executives who led IL&FS. Yash is here with a quick wrap-out. Yash.
Well, Prashant, to start with the headline which came out of that very long hearing in the IL&FS matter at NCLT, essentially the National Company Law Tribunal has asked all the key executives of IL&FS, the erstwhile management, to disclose their movable and immovable assets before the tribunal. Not just that, essentially these assets will include all bank lockers, the bank accounts, not just in India, but also overseas. This is one part of the order. The second part of the order essentially prevents these key management people or executives to essentially create any third-party rights on these movable and immovable assets, be it in the form of mortgaging them or essentially creating any sort of third-party rights as far as these assets are concerned. The final and the most crucial part of the order, these respondents are also prevented from selling any of their stake in any of the IL&FS listed subsidiaries. This is as far as the order is concerned, but a very crucial order based on some very crucial arguments which came from the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, which was essentially premised on the preliminary SFIO investigation which has been going on. To just point out some of the crucial findings, essentially SFIO has filed this report through MCA before NCLT, and essentially it brings out instances of siphoning of funds, failure in corporate governance, conflict of interest, as well as undue personal enrichment which was done by these key management people from the erstwhile management as far as IL&FS as well as its group companies are concerned. There were specific instances which were narrated before the tribunal. To point out a few of them, the point of disproportionate remuneration as far as the key management people are concerned, siphoning of funds, as I mentioned, as well as mismanagement and lack of independence when it comes to the functioning of various IL&FS subsidiaries. Now, the bottom line, as far as the order is concerned, these movable and immovable assets will have to be disclosed before the tribunal within the next 3 weeks, and the next hearing will take place on January 16th.
Okay, so January 16th is the next day as far as IL&FS goes at the NCLT. Thanks, Yash, for getting us those details. Right now, it's time to get back to the market. Market which is trading in a narrow band. So neither are the bears able to make any sort of a big headway, nor are the bulls getting anywhere. It's absolutely range-bound today. So let's get you some ideas from the futures and options market. Okay, I think we'll have Gaurav Bissa with those ideas in just a moment. Let's take a break and we'll come back with the F&O trades.